budget. How have you been? Where's everybody? Did you just get here? Do you want something to drink?
Hi, Bill.
I remember it.
Nice to see you.
Sewer line.
50.
Come on.
And if you find later that you want more,
sorry,
you
okay.
can either.
We got these cards.
You can either take a card and call this place, or you can call me and I'll get it.
Okay.
Where are we going to go?
To San Diego.
Okay, here we go.
See you later.
Can you say see you later, John?
See you later, John.
Okay, Henry, see you later.
Bye.
We'll be down there. See y'all.
Well, we're doing a thing that Molly set up with. She set up the teams, and then you just play everybody.
Yeah.
And then at the end, the two people with the best, most number of games, because we play three games against each person, the two people with the most number of games play each other in this one.
I turned around, there was a pickup truck, and the driver with a beard and whatever leaned out, and he said, "Hey, you were pretty good in that tennis game today." He said, "I'll bet you were really good when you were young."
Youngest.
Hey, I'm just getting some coverage here.
Hello.
Any steps they make, any money that's spent.
Of course. And hey, sweet. Here's the boy.
Oh, he likes to grab for the lens.
Which one should I use?
Hi, Peggy.
Can I video you?
Sure. For a minute.
How do I do it?
It's done. It's done now. Like, I'm done already. Just had a nice game of ball with Henry. That was a lot of fun. And we're looking forward to the bocce tournament coming up next. And there's a scavenger hunt underway, well underway.
Scavenger hunt! How could I forget? Oh, where do you see this?
All the powers with the clipboard.
We got a long
piece of hair.
Who's winning?
Well, it's very close.
All right.
Well, let's see.
It's kind of two pieces.
Okay, let's take that hair and put it under the nail clipper. Right here, Mary.
And now.
As far as tomorrow is concerned, anybody that is engaged in the sandcastle building contest, which is going to be terrific, I want you to see Sarah. There she is.
First of all, I'm on the senior division of castling on the Ohio River 2 weeks before I came out here. And so I was seated in this competition.
Oh, I see. All right.
Yeah.
Poor Mary, Mike. That boat stroke we had demonstrated.
Yeah, the castle that I built, though, was Glendale. Cincinnati's known as a town of many hills and a valley going through it, and the Ohio River goes through it.
That was the moat stroke, wasn't it?
Price's Hill is where my grandparents met each other.
Right.
And then they went from that hill over to Walnut Hills, where they became engaged. They were married between Walnut Hills and the train station, which was built, and they were both very fond of the train station.
And represented.
They got married, and shortly after that, they took their wedding trip, not their honeymoon, their wedding trip. And then they came back, and they lived in Glendale, Ohio, where I live now.
Take the fan and fan them all. No, don't break it. I said take it. You thought I said break it. No, it sounds the same. I mean, I should speak more distinctly. Now, Barankau. Now you will, I'll get a magic wand. We'll fix it. Don't worry. This is me.
While you're just getting settled, there's a couple of things I want to say. We've got a couple of announcements about the activity this afternoon. But, you know, there's 263 eligibles of the descendants of John Jay and Leota. And 140 of us are here today, and it's a great group.
So we thought, who else is a champion in our book here? And the immediate choice was the venerable player today, who not only also played for Pardo, but took a smoking break in between each match.
Jack's team, and there was a certain point that we played, and Jack measured the distance between the white ball, and it's called the man. What the yeah? It's called that white ball, and Dad's ball, and he took his shoe off and started measuring it one by one, and we called Rome, and they said, in fact, that is an illegal measure. And we'll have to throw out that result entirely, therefore they default. The winner of the bocce tournament is our team, Nan, myself. One of the things I've noticed ever since we got here, and I feel it in every conversation, it's unspoken, but I feel it, which is that every time I'm talking to someone, I just feel how much they want to know more about me. Well, this doesn't seem the place for that, but I have a website. www.boytoy.com. The one thing I wanted to say about Mother is that if Mother were here, nobody would have gotten a word in and nobody would have enjoyed it more. We sure miss her. I think at every age, how she would be enjoying everybody. Aunt Allie knew it. She knows you never meet anyone before Aunt Allie met. And one day she called me over to her house and she said, "Well, you won't believe what I've done." And I said, "What?" She said, "I auditioned for Woody Allen." I said, "You what?" And I thought, this is it. She snapped. She's going in and dancing. She's gone through the gate. Aunt Allie's great love, maybe even more than the opera, but probably not as much as church, was the bus. She loved that bus, and she knew more about how to take public transportation in New York on a bus. And she knew take the M4 to the M16, then transfer over to the Q32 for two blocks, and she knew everything about how the bus system worked. So when Speed opened, which was all about the movie All Set, they finally, she was 93, but they made the movie for you. You waited long enough. So I called her. I said, "There's a movie for you. It's called Speed. It's set on a bus." She said, "When do we go?"
What's the
start introducing each other and get to know each other, because you guys are going to do a lot of team things together.
Yeah, we only need one of these because there's only going to be one score at a time. Right, John? Let's put this
But hey, you know, I never knew there was such a thing as a nudist resort.
I didn't either.
People who don't wear any clothes.
You don't wear any clothes?
No.
People may forget what you say. People may forget when you said it. But they're never going to forget how they felt when you said it. And I think that is it.
Woody, have you ever tried acupuncture?
Kept it going, and he was the flame behind it all. And he came in and put a team together with my son Andy and a few others, and they made a perfectly wonderful thing out of this party, which, in all fairness, is more than anyone could expect. So I would say, let's be glad for that.
And there's Sam, Molly, Zoe, and Peggy.
Second bomb underneath that they don't even know about.